In today's big data context, the previous approaches are either incomplete or suboptimal. For example, the SEMA methodology disregards completely data collection and pre-processing of different data sources. These stages normally constitute most of the work in a successful big data project. We begin by realizing that there are two sides to the analytics lifecycle: discovery and deployment. Let's take a look at the tasks for both sides and see how they interact to create an iterative process that you can use to produce repeatable, reliable, predictive results. The first phase is the discovery phase of the analytics lifecycle. Ask a question. The discovery process is driven by asking business questions that produce innovations. So, the first step is defining what the business needs to know, and then translating the business question into a mathematical representation of the problem, which can be solved with predictive analytics. Business people also need to specify the need, scope, market conditions, and goals related to a business question they are trying to answer, which helps in the selection of the most appropriate modeling techniques. Prepare the data. Technologies like Hadoop and faster, cheaper computers have made it possible to store and use more data and more types of data than ever before. But this has only amplified the need to join data in different formats from different sources and transform raw data so that it can be used as input for predictive modeling. With new data types from connected devices, such as machine sensor data or web logs from online interactions, the data preparation stage has become even more challenging. Many organizations still report that they spend an inordinate amount of time, sometimes up to 80%, dealing with data preparation tasks. The majority of time in the discovery phase should be spent on exploring data and creating good models instead of preparing data. Explore the data. Interactive, self-service visualization tools need to serve a wide range of users, from the business analyst with no statistical knowledge to the analytically savvy data scientist, so they can easily search for relationships, trends, and patterns to gain deeper understanding of the data. In this step, the question and the approach formed in the initial ask phase of the project will be refined. Ideas on how to address the problem from an analytical perspective are developed and tested. While examining the data, you may find the need to add, delete, or combine variables to create more precisely focused models. Fast, interactive tools help make this an iterative process, which is crucial for identifying the best questions and answers. Model the data. In this stage, numerous analytical and machine learning modeling algorithms are applied to the data to find the best representation of the relationships in the data that will help answer the business question. Analytical tools search for a combination of data and modeling techniques that reliably predict a desired outcome. There is no single algorithm that always performs best. The best algorithm for solving the problem depends on the data. Experimentation is key to finding the most reliable answer, and automated model building can help minimize the time to results and boost the productivity of analytical teams. In the past, data miners and data scientists were only able to create several models in a week or month using manual model building tools. Improved software and faster computers have sped up the model building process, so hundreds or even thousands of models can be created today in the same time frame. But that brings to the surface another issue: how to quickly and reliably identify the one model that performs best. Model tournaments provide a way to compare many different competing algorithms with the opportunity to choose the one that provides the best results for a specific set of data. With automated tournaments of machine learning algorithms and clearly defined metrics to identify the champion model, this has become an easier process. Analysts and data scientists can spend their time focusing on more strategic questions and investigations. The second phase is the deployment phase of the analytics lifecycle. Implement your models. This is where you take the insights learned from the discovery phase and put them into action using repeatable, automated processes. In many organizations, this is the point where the analytical modeling process slows dramatically because there is no defined transition between discovery and deployment, or collaboration between the model developers and IT deployment architects, much less optimized automation. In most organizations, the deployment environment is very different from the discovery environment, especially when the predictive models are supporting operational decision-making. Often, IT has to apply rigorous governance policies to this environment to ensure service-level agreements with the business. By integrating the discovery and deployment phases, you can create an automated, flexible, and repeatable transition that improves operational decisions. Additionally, a transparent, governed process is important for everyone, especially auditors. Once built, the model is registered, tested or validated, approved and declared ready to be used with production data embedded into operational systems. Act on new information. There are two types of decisions that can be made based on analytical results. Strategic decisions are made by humans who examine results and take action, usually looking to the future. Operational decisions are automated, like credit scores or recommended best offers. They don't require human intervention because the rules that humans would apply can be coded into the production systems. More and more organizations are looking to automate operational decisions and provide real-time results to reduce decision latencies. Basing operational decisions on answers from analytical models also makes these decisions objective, consistent, repeatable, and measurable. Integration of models with enterprise decision management tools enables organizations to build comprehensive and complete operational decision flows. These combine analytical models with business rule-based triggers to produce the best automated decisions. And because this is formally defined within the decision management tool, updates and refinements to changing conditions are easy, improving business agility and governance. Once approved for production, the decision management tool applies the model to new operational data, generating the predictive insights necessary for better actions. Evaluate your results. The next and perhaps most important step is to evaluate the outcome of the actions produced by the analytical model. Did your models produce the correct predictions? Were tangible results realized, such as increased revenue or decreased costs? With continuous monitoring and measurement of the model's performance based on standardized metrics, you can evaluate the success of these assets for your business. That evaluation can then feed the next iteration of the model, creating a continuous machine learning loop. If you identify degradation of analytical models, you can define the optimal strategy to refresh them so they continue to produce the desired results. With increasing numbers of analytical models, automation is necessary to quickly identify models that need the most attention and even deliver automated retraining. Ask again. Predictive models are not forever. The factors that drive the predictions in a model change over time, your customers change over time, competitors enter or leave the market, and new data becomes available. You have to refresh even the most accurate models, and organizations will need to go through the discovery and deployment steps again. It's a constant and evolving process. If a model degrades, it is recalibrated by changing the model coefficients or rebuilt with existing and new characteristics. When the model no longer serves a business need, it is retired. In summary, in an effective analytical environment, data is rapidly created and accessed in the correct structure for exploration and model development. Models are rapidly built and tested, and deployed into a production environment with minimal delay. Production models quickly generate trusted output. Model performance is constantly monitored, and underperforming models are quickly replaced by more up-to-date models. In short, a successful analytics strategy means more than creating a powerfully predictive model, it is about managing each of these lifecycle stages holistically for a particular model and across the entire portfolio of models. This is no easy feat, consider that analysts and data scientists don't just develop one model to solve a problem. They develop a set of competing models and use different techniques to address complex problems. They will have models at various stages of development and models tailored for different product lines and business problems. An organization can quickly find itself managing thousands of models. Furthermore, the model environment is anything but static. Models will be continually updated as they are tested and as new results and data become available. The goal is to build the best predictive models possible, using the best data available.